Why are you running? Why are you running?
When you talk about movies that I haven't seen, A Trip to Jamaica will be one of them. And why I waited so long to see it was because of the audience. On one end, you have people that love it and find it funny. And on the other end, you have people who don't like it and find it cringeworthy. So because of that, I decided to stay on the fence and just avoid it completely. But after I saw it on the Airtel TV app, I decided to give it a chance and determine if A Trip to Jamaica was ever funny.
Chop that. My babe, good so.
Is this your house?
Be like the full St. Andrew Cathedral for.
The story follows Apoch proposing to his girl on national television just after he ran up a stage meant for comedians. You know, this can only happen in a movie because normally he should have been yeeted off the stage. Then after she accepted, they go on their pre-honeymoon vacation, which was in America. Pre-honeymoon vacation. Jeez. Have money, yo. Guys, have money. It's not even the honeymoon, it's the pre. Have money. The reason they did this vacation in America was because Bola's sister Abigail stays there. And as soon as Abigail sees them, she realized that she made a huge mistake.
My name is Apos Oborogeneru Omokoro Dafe, aka Bumpy.
Abigail is married to a white man who is also rich. You know what they say, if you are going to marry a white man, make sure he has money. Yeah. At first, it looked like the normal interracial rich couple that they have a big house, drive nice expensive cars. Then you start noticing the normal routine you see in rich homes. Someone is always not happy. I don't even know why. But that person that is not happy is Abigail. And that's because she is in this possessive marriage. And from her facial expression, it looks like she's a prisoner in her home and definitely wants to leave. Nigerian ladies be like, how possessive is he? I'm asking for a friend. She likes possessive men. But slowly, Bola starts noticing her sister's subtle fade from reality. One moment she's smiling, the next moment she's sad. One moment she's smiling, the next moment she's sad. One moment she's smiling, the next moment she's crying wet. They then go to Jamaica because Abigail's husband, Michael, is a wanted man. And he does all sorts of things, from drugs to money laundry to racketeering. I can't pronounce it. And that's just the basis of the movie. And I guess you guys must be wondering,
Prince, is that all? Prince, where are the jokes?
First off, that's not all. There's still more to the movie. But I can't spoil it for you guys. But yeah, the jokes.
And then to the left of Patrick for around that day.
Put them on the phone. You know, tell them, say they're not rich. They don't know how they run at this side.
Say no about Jamaica.
Can also do party for me.
Eh?
First one, they are going to be getting to play
violin. Eh?
Apos and Bola have this very unstable relationship. 80% of the movie was just them being toxic.
Oh, Apos, you see they see that girl on my girl, like? You see they run things with that girl, right? Abi?
They are capable of giving a relationship therapist a run for his money. And the weird thing about their relationship is when they have those cute moments where they are all lovey-dovey, it removes the toxicity. To be honest, I think that's how toxic relationship works. One moment they're happy, the next moment they're... Okay, cool. I see. Yeah, sorry. Both of them complement themselves very well. For Apos, he's capable of making any scene awkward. And I generally and genuinely like how cringe he is. I'm not even lying. And maybe I think it's because I'm watching it in 2020 and I was not watching it in 2006. But I love how cringe he is.
I did get my own package, you know, they always take the work out.
Anytime I travel, the carrier.
Yeah, spread. Yeah. Spread it like the gospel.
Bola, on the other hand, is way more level-headed when compared to Apos. Don't get me wrong, guys. She's still mad. She's still mad. Now, the question is, how funny is this movie? To me, I think it is funny. And I guess it's because I'm watching it now, as I said earlier. Side note, guys, I don't know if this was the aim of the movie, but if it was, I appreciate this movie more. You see, for Apos, it seemed like he was an over-exaggerated version of the Worry Boy sketch. If you guys don't know, in Nigeria, there's this constant use of the name Apos. And the main reason Apos can be used by different comedians is because Apos can be considered as someone that is local, someone that is naturally unlucky. You know how unlucky you have to be naturally unlucky? That is Akpos. And you already know the bad are the jokes. Some of the jokes fell flat. But trust me, if you are watching it this year, it is very bearable.
Everyone, jarros of fried rice.
So can I ask you guys a question? When was the last time you got a new phone? I will answer that question for you. Never. My brother told me how to taste the bag. Guys, I have said it before and I'm saying it again. Airtel has an app for movies. You can watch movies and many more things on the app. It doesn't end there. You also get 1.5 free data monthly with a max of 50 MB daily. You can stand a chance to win one smartphone weekly and 50,000 naira. Think about it, you get to see a movie for free and you also get data. Do you understand? And if you're hungry, they are like, don't worry, man, I got you. Take 50,000 there. So you guys support me by downloading the app using the link in my description and also the first pinned comment in the comment section, obviously. At the end, it's just a feel-good movie that was made for families to watch and laugh, and I can't fault it for that. So is it funny? Yes, it is. So watch it. And wait, is this how stylish Jamaican policemen are? What? I talk back, talk smack, talk racks, even when I got none. Run around, cause a scene, circle back, blame it on a brother, man. Consciously, I'm overly defensive, memory is awkwardly retentive, keeping tabs on all that.